អង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះអង្គជុះ Thank you. Good afternoon again, witness. Is it fair to say that when you came back from your training in Phnom Penh and went to the airfield for the second time, your conditions
improved?
And were others in your unit doing the same work that you did when you first went to the airfield? I'd just like to talk about hygiene. When you were there for the first 2 months before the training, did workers from your unit, did they get to wash and shower? Did they have bath facilities, toilets, all those facilities to keep clean and healthy?
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមស្រាវជ្រាវអង្គជំនុំថាមុនពេលដែលខ្ញុំបាទបានចូលទៅបណ្ដោះបណ្ដាលគ្មានអនាម័យសូម្បីតែម្ហូបគឺរុយរោមហើយបាក់រុយនោះគឺហូបអត់មានអនាម័យទេនេះសូមអង្គជំនុំមេត្តាជ្រាប
You mentioned earlier that you saw people die from starvation and overwork. What happened to their bodies? Were they given a funeral ceremony? Were they buried? Were they cremated? Do you know what happened to
them?
Did workers from your unit have the opportunity to leave the work site and visit families and friends? Does that mean that when people were working, they were guarded? by guards.
Ta chăng miền này tha miền nẻ diêm đài khlom mơ rư có diêm nẻ thơ ca hành chăng rư có yang na.
Cái miền nẻ diêm tam khlom mơ nẻ pê na đà jeung đà chênh pi ong phiep cứ tha jeung khmăng miền ta pnoh ba.
Did the guards carry weapons or not?
Sam nua. Ta ne yiem nang mien avot dai rute.
Ne yiem nei angkhep no. Khmien kan ka phleung te. Dai rute doi khnie.
Did the guards wear different clothes to the people that were working? Can you explain about how many guards there were? For example, if there was 30 or 40 workers working in an area, would there be one guard or two guards or more guards? Can you give us an idea of the proportion of people doing the work, the labor, compared to those guarding? And did any of those guards come from your unit,
K4?
You mentioned that there were members from Division 450 at the airfield in your statement. Were any of those members of that division, were any of them guards? And did you know which military division or military unit that was running the airfield, operating it, managing it? And one last question on this. Do you know which military group the guards may have belonged to.
Dung Darute, Tata, Net Jim, no look at Hanpulin, and Hotang Ahanung, Chum no, our Uncle Pip Nadai.
Chim bát, bum bán dung tay, Net Jim, Nick Coin, the pay yup, kid out tam, mock lane, Jim, some rap.
And talking about when you were with your unit before you went for training, did the guards get the same work conditions as your unit? Did they have to work as long? You've talked about having insufficient food when you were there for the first time. You talked about people dying of overwork and of starvation. Did you see any of the guards dying of starvation or overwork? I'm just asking what you saw. Did you see any guard die of starvation or overwork? Or was it just the workers that you saw die of that?
ឬក៏លោកធ្លាប់ឃើញថាអ្នកកម្មករទេដែលស្លាប់ដោយអត់អាហារនឹងធ្វើការហួសកម្លាំងនេះខ្ញុំបាទសូមបញ្ជាក់ជូនអង្គជំនុំម្ដងទៀតហើយអ្នកដែលយាមកាមមិនដែលឃើញស្លាប់ទេដែលឃើញស្លាប់ដោយសារអត់អាហារគឺមានតែពលករដូចគ្នាបាទ
And if the worker was feeling ill, did you ever see any of the workers ill or unwell? And would they get medical treatment? Did they get medical treatment from what you saw? When you were at the airfield, could you complain about not having enough food? Could you complain about having to work too hard? Could you complain about not having enough hygiene facilities to wash? Did you feel comfortable complaining about that when you were there?
តើលោកមានលទ្ធភាពឬក៏មានសិទ្ធិសេរីភាពនិយាយអំពីបញ្ហាកង្វះខាតទាំងអស់នេះដោយមិនមានការភ័យខ្លាចដែរឬទេក្នុងការហូបចុកដែលខ្វះអនាម័យមិនដែលហ៊ានលាន់មាត់ទេសូម្បីតែស្លមកជូរត្រកួនគេដាក់ចង្រិតក៏ចេះតែត្រាំលេបដោយសារខ្លាចណាចគេបាទ
And can you remind us why you couldn't complain? What was the atmosphere like at the airfield? Why did you not feel comfortable to complain?
ក្នុងសភាពដែលយើងត្អូញត្អែរកិច្ចការយើងទម្រន់យើងខ្សែខ្មាំងដូច្នេះកិច្ចការងារទាំងឡាយគឺខំមាត់សង្កត់ចិត្តមិនហ៊ានតបតនឹងគេទោះបីគេឲ្យហូបយ៉ាងណាក៏ដោយធ្វើការយ៉ាងណាក៏ដោយសេចក្តីខំមាត់សង្កត់ចិត្តឲ្យទៅបានរស់ក្នុងមួយគ្រាបាទ
And just briefly, on the all the different work activities that were going on at the airfield, from what you can remember, both before your training and after your training, can you tell us the types of work that was being done to build the airfield and the buildings around? What types of things were people doing? ในขนมสกรรมเพียบการนี้เพื่อเปลี่ยนยนต์ฮะคือเมียนจราจรจราจรประเภทเมียนเนื้อคลาสทางจีอันใดตามเรือเนื้อคลาสคือจีสมัยมีนมาจำไหนคือเมียนตรัสเตอร์โอ้ใดติจักมีนมาจำไหนคือในเรียบทมาคือทมาโกที่อังกฤษเซ็งเซ็งปีนี้เมียนจราจร And the activities that you did before you went to Phnom Penh, I think you said you were pulling grass. What other activities were you doing before you learned how to be a land surveyor?
เรียนมุ่นนึงเรียนยกจำแนกข้างเนี่ยตรงใดเนี่ยโลกเมียนทัวร์ไอ้เซนเทียได้กลายไปดอกสมัยนึง
มันไปฉบับแต่เรียนในพรมเพ็งเมียนตัวนาทีดอกสมัยจีจันได้ตามเรื่อง
And were others in your unit assigned to do that as well? And was your leg still a problem said you had a broken leg.
Was
there any lasting pain or injury coming from that leg whilst you were working?
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមជម្រាបជូនអង្គជំនុំជម្រះធ្វើការនៅពេលនោះទៅទាំងចិត្តពេលឈរឈឺជើងខ្ញុំបាទមិនធានាដូចជើងអ្នកដែលជាទេពេលដែលធ្វើការគឺខ្ញុំបាទមានទឹកភ្នែករំដងដោយសារជើងរបស់ខ្លួន
And can you tell us how it felt? How it felt to be pulling the grass with the injured leg, with insufficient food, with lack of sleep, with no hygiene facilities. How did it feel? Can you describe that to the court? Please.
ក្នុងលក្ខខណ្ឌបែបនេះនេះលោកទទួលអារម្មណ៍យ៉ាងណាដែរលោកអាចពិពណ៌នាអំពីអារម្មណ៍របស់លោកជូនតុលាការបន្តិចបានទេខ្ញុំបាទសូមជម្រាបជូនអង្គតុលាការសូមមេត្តាជ្រាបខ្ញុំបាទទទួលអារម្មណ៍ថាខ្ញុំបាទហាក់ដូចជាមនុស្សស្លាប់នៅពេលនោះអត់មានសង្ឃឹមថាបានរស់រានមានជីវិត ទៅជួបនឹងអ្នកមានគុណរបស់ខ្ញុំបាទទេនឹកឃើញថាថ្ងៃណាមួយនឹងគឺត្រូវស្លាប់ដោយសារការងារពលកម្មឬក៏ក្នុងអាហារមិនគ្រប់គ្រាន់ហើយនឹកឃើញថានឹកឪពុកម្ដាយរាប់ឆ្នាំមិនដែលបានឃើញឬសំណឹងដោយសារបែកពីឪពុកម្ដាយ រាល់ថ្ងៃជួងកាមានការដេកយំម្នាក់ឯងដោយនឹកឪពុកនិងម្ដាយបែរណាការងារខ្លួនក៏ធ្ងន់ធ្ងរនេះខ្ញុំបាទសូមជម្រាបជូនអង្គតុលាការសូមមេត្តាជ្រាបទាន
Did the guards were the guards treated differently to you and your unit? Did the guards have the same conditions that you've just talked
about? ចំពោះអ្នកយាមមិនដែលឃើញទៅធ្វើការជាមួយពលករទេឃើញមួយតែពេលយប់ពេលដែលពលករចូលសម្រាកហើយមិនអាចមិនមានសិទ្ធិនិយាយជាមួយគេបានទេណាខ្ញុំសូមអង្គជំនុំមេត្តាជ្រាប
Thank you. Mr. Witness, I'd like to move to another topic, if we can. Moving away from the conditions that people endured at the airfield and discussing a little more about arrests that occurred. You said to us that before you came to the airfield, there were arrests in your division. But now, I would like you to think about when you were at the airfield, were there arrests occurring? And I want, before you answer, I want to refresh your memory with the statement that you gave to the investigator as to what you said And then we can ask, have a discussion about that. I'm referring back to the original statement that was quoted, Mr. President. In your statement, you said trucks came to arrest people every night, arresting about 20 each time. At meetings, they called out names for people to leave the meeting and to be arrested at once. Of my unit, only 14 remain alive. Is that correct? When you were at the airfield, these frequent arrests were continuing every night.
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមថ្លែងជូនអង្គតុលាការសូមមេត្តាជ្រាប
Are you saying then, from the 400 people that were in your unit before you went to the airfield, only 14 you've only seen 14 again since 1979. Is that correct?
ឬក៏លោកចង់និយាយថាក្រោយឆ្នាំ1979លោកបានជួបមុខមនុស្សនៅក្នុងឆ្នាំ 1979 តែ 14 នាក់ប៉ុណ្ណោះខ្ញុំបាទសូមឆ្លើយជូនអង្គជំនុំជម្រះនៅពេលក្រោយឆ្នាំ 79គឺបានជួបគ្នាតែ 14 នាក់
Of the men that you remember in your unit, K4, other than those 14, have you ever seen those men again?
ក្រៅពីអ្នកទាំង14អ្នកនេះតើលោកធ្លាប់ជួបអ្នកផ្សេងទៀតទេខ្ញុំបាទសូមឆ្លើយជូនអង្គតុលាការសូមមេត្តាជ្រាបក្រៅពីអ្នក14អ្នកដែលគេចាប់ទៅនេះមិនដែលឃើញវិលមកវិញនេះសូមមេត្តាជ្រាប
We'll talk about the intense period where there were arrests from your unit before you went to the airfield. But for now, is it the case that there were arrests at the airfield that you saw and trucks came with people to arrest them? Is that correct?
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមឆ្លើយជូនអង្គជំនុំជម្រះនៅវគ្គកោបួនក៏ដូចជា317 គឺមានចាប់ច្រើនតែដល់ទៅកំពង់ឆ្នាំងខ្ញុំបាទមិនសូវបានឃើញទេសូមមេត្តាជ្រាប
Did Did you see any arrests at Camp Ponchanang? And if you saw any arrests, can you explain what happened?
ពលានញ្ញហោះកំពុងឆ្នាំងនៅរីទេបើរកធ្លាប់ឃើញតែមានរឿងអ្វីកើតឡើងដែរនៅពេលនោះខ្ញុំបាទសូមថ្លែងជូនអង្គតុលាការសមេតាជ្រាបនៅកំពង់ឆ្នាំងមានឃើញប៉ុន្តែតិចជាងនៅក្មួយកប់ស្រូវដែលគេថាខ្សែខ្មាំងចាប់មិនអស់
Are you saying that there were arrests at Camp Ponchanang of people from your unit, even if they weren't as frequent as the other place?
ទោះបីថាការចាប់ខ្លួននឹងវាមិនចាប់ខ្លួនញឹកញាប់ដូចនៅកន្លែងផ្សេងក៏ដោយចុះលោកចន់និយាយអញ្ចឹងឬក៏យ៉ាងណាអ្នកដែលទៅចាប់ខ្លួននៅកំពង់ឆ្នាំង
Can you explain, even though they weren't that frequent? Can you explain how an arrest at Camp Ponchanang occurred from what you saw?
How did it happen?
And do you know in which direction that individual was taken?
តើលោកដឹងដែរឬទេថាតើគេនាំអ្នកដែលគេចាប់ខ្លួននោះទៅទិសណាដែរខ្ញុំបាទខ្ញុំបានដឹងថាគេនាំអ្នកដែលចាប់ខ្លួននោះទៅខាងណាទេ
Thank you. Now, I'd like to go back to when you were working at Khmer Kop Sorao, sorry for the pronunciation. Before you went to the airfield, you said there were very frequent arrests in your unit.
And
if I can just read what you have said to the investigator at the ECC, E3/467, English 0020-5073, Khmer 0017-0618 and 9, French 0020-5077. And this is what you said. What did they have you do there? How many people were there? And what were the conditions like? This is at K4 now, not at the airfield. This is before you've arrived at the airfield. And you said, at K4, there were 600 handicapped soldiers. They forced us, the entire unit, to make 4 hectares of rice fields per day. The food was insufficient. Some people died to starvation.
I
saw 36 to 37 with my own eyes. Tatu was the person in charge of Unit 4, K4. He also came from the North Zone and was later arrested. I don't want to talk about the conditions at Khmer Kop Sarao, but I want to talk about the arrests in your division, in your unit. And you go on to say, did you ever see them arrest people? Why were they arrested? You said, I saw them arrest many people, transporting them by Land Rover. They came to arrest 4 to 10 people every night. They came to arrest them directly at the site. Sometimes they called them to Phnom Penh for arrest. They accused all of those arrested of being CIA links. During those arrests, they tied their arms behind their backs, parrot wing style, stuffed them in bags, and tossed them right into the vehicles. Is this the intense period of arrests that you were talking about before you went to the
airfield?
And can you explain to the court, in your own words, your own words today, how those arrests would happen? What did you see?
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមឆ្លើយជំរាបជូនអង្គតុលាការសូមមេត្តាជ្រាបនៅពេលដែលគេចាប់ម្ដងៗគេហៅប្រជុំទាំងអស់ឲ្យតម្រង់ជាជួរហើយគេហៅឈ្មោះអ្នកដែលត្រូវចាប់ខ្លួនចេញទៅមុខពេលដែលគេចង់ស្លាប់សេចហើយគេឲ្យអង្គុយគេបោះបាយពីលើធាក់ពន្លោះចាំមាត់បាយលើកបោះដាក់ឡើង
Would everyone from your unit be called to these meetings? Would everyone see it? Or only the people that were arrested were called to the meeting? Can you help us understand what it was like when these arrests were continuing at Khmer Kop Sarao?
តើលោកអាចពន្យល់អំពីអ្វីដែលប្រទៅក្នុងពេលការចាប់ខ្លួននឹងបានដែរឬទេនៅក្មួយកប់ស្រូវនឹងនៅក្មួយកប់ត្រូវខ្ញុំបាទសូមឆ្លើយបំភ្លឺអង្គតុលាការសូមមេត្តាជ្រាបនៅពេលដែលគេទៅចាប់គេប្រមូលទាំងអស់ប្រជុំមិនមែនហៅតែអ្នកដែលត្រូវចាប់ទេគឺគេហៅប្រជុំទាំងអស់គ្នាឲ្យឈរតម្រង់ជួរហើយគេហៅឈ្មោះអ្នកដែលត្រូវចាប់ខ្លួនទៅជួរមុខបាទនេះសូមអង្គតុលាការមេត្តាជ្រាបនៅពេលនោះ
In this intense period of arrest, you have in your statement They came to arrest 4 to 10 people every night. Is that correct? You were being called to meetings every night, and people would be taken out of those meetings and taken
away.
And from what you remember, even if the meetings are getting smaller and smaller, but how many people were initially at these meetings? How many people from your unit would be going into the meeting? Would it be 10, 20, 40, 100, or the whole unit? Can you explain, please?
ដល់អ្នកមកភ័យអ្នកសាមសិបអ្នកសាមសិបអ្នកហើយកងគេផ្សេងទៀតនោះក៏ចុះដូចគ្នាដែរអ្នកដែលចូលរួមប្រជុំនោះឬក៏យ៉ាងណាលោកអាចបញ្ចូលតឡាការបន្តិចបានទេខ្ញុំបាទសូមជម្រាបជូនអង្គតឡាការសូមមេត្តាជ្រាបមិនមែនតែកងខ្ញុំបាទមួយទេគឺគ្រប់កងទាំងអស់ក្នុងអង្គភាព
317. So can you give me can you give the court an example of the numbers of people that would have had to attend one of those meetings? Is it in the hundreds, or is it in the 20s and 30s, or any other number? How big were they, or how small were they? And how were the meetings called? Who would call the meeting? Would it be the unit chief of K4 or the other unit chiefs? Who would call the meeting?
តាអ្នកណាជាអ្នកមានសិទ្ធិកោះប្រជុំខ្ញុំបាទសូមជម្រាបជូនអង្គតុលាការសូមមេត្តាជ្រាបនៅអង្គភាព317នេះអត់មានកោះ៤ទេគឺ317ដែលគេចាប់ច្រើននេះគឺ317
Thank you. In your statement, you give some more information about how these arrests occurred. And I'd like to read it to you to see if it refreshes your memory as to the facts. You were asked, who came to make the arrest? And you said, the security people came with the vehicles, with Praesar and Tool Sling markers. I know that Praesar and Tool Sling were prisons. Because the leaders always threatened that anyone who was lazy or who did wrong would be sent to Praesar or Tool Sling. In 1976, they began to arrest the leaders in the southwest zone. And during 1977, they arrested the leaders from the north zone. They arrested all the leaders from division level down to the squad leaders. I personally saw them arrest chairman of K4, Tatu, the deputy chairman, Ta Sen, and Ta Rum, who was in charge of logistics. Before their arrest, they called a meeting of the troops, and they called those three to the front. I did not know who made the arrests. They announced that they had come to arrest traitors. I never saw those who were arrested return. Is that correct? You saw the unit chief, the deputy chief, and the man in charge of logistics, Ta Rum, arrested on that day?
លោកបានឃើញមែនឬក៏អត់ទេខ្ញុំបាទសំថ្លៃជូនអង្គតុលាការថានៅពេលនោះគឺខ្ញុំបាទនៅស្ដាប់ការប្រជុំនឹងគេបានឃើញដោយពិតប្រាកដអត់មានលាក់លៀមបាទ
And you were also asked at E34467 English 0020 5073, Khmer 0017 0619, French 0020 5077. You answered this question and you was asked of you, aside from the three leaders, did you see them arrest other leaders? And you said, I saw them arrest company chairman Ta Sim and Ta Veng. In 1977, they arrested Ta Un. They announced that Ta Un, Ta Kim, and Ta Yet were CIA links. They had a meeting in July 1977, and at that time they announced, your leaders are CIA and are traitors. What do you think about that? When all the leaders from the North Zone had been arrested, the South Zone would come to take control in their places. After that, they sent you to Kampong Chenang. My first question is this also correct, that you saw these company chairmen, Ta Sim and Ta Veng, be arrested?
បានឃើញពិតប្រាកដមែននៅពេលនោះ
Thank you. And just so we understand it a little more,
ខ្ញុំ ចង់ ស្វែង យល់ ឲ្យ បាន ច្រើន បន្តិច
ខ្ញុំ Cop Srau, that area,
no, ខ្មួញ,
that was a
Cop Srau, តំបន់ ខ្មួញ Cop Srau
នេះ, was it a rice farming area?
តើ ជា វាល
ស្រែ? And then did it have buildings as well? Can you explain what that area was? You said you worked there for quite a while. So we understand where these arrests are occurring. The physical layout, if you can.
លោកសូមលោករៀបរាប់អំពីទីតាំងភូមិសាស្ត្រក្មួយនិងកប់ស្រូវជូនអង្គជំនួយប្រាំបន្តិចបានទេខ្ញុំបាទសូមរៀបរាប់ជូនអង្គតុលាការសមិតាទានជ្រាប នៅក្មួយនិងកប់ស្រូវគឺនៅតាមផ្ទះរបស់ប្រជាជនដែលគេជំនះចេញទៅនៅភូមិចាស់របស់គេគឺមានផ្ទះនៅសេសសល់ក៏នៅហ្នឹងហើយនៅកន្លែងនោះទៅដល់គឺឲ្យនៅ
Is it correct that you went to quite a lot of these meetings where people were taken away and arrested?
Is that correct?
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមរៀបរាប់ជូនអង្គតុលាការ rương đề kỳ hai của chung tràn đoàn hai kỳ chấp mà nó chanh tới bắt kiếm bắt xâm trai chung ông tà la ca kiểu bất và cắt mềm nếu kiếm bắt xâm bắt chung ông tà la ca kiểu bàn khơi để bất cọt
And what would make you, what made you go to the meeting? Because obviously, very quickly, you were learning that if you went to the meeting, there was a chance that you would be arrested and taken away. Why would you go to the meetings if you knew that was like that could happen to you? Perhaps if I do it another way. Did you have any choice as to whether you went to the meeting or not?
Ta lúc miền chấm rớt ai tụ tập chung cỏ bán mình tụ tập chung cỏ bán bán đại được tiền.
Nơi bên đó mình ai miền chấm rớt tại cái hai tụ tập chung sắp khí thì rơi tới tới mà anh ai đã khán bàn và dừng.
So who would make the call to go to the meetings? How would you find out in the day that there was a meeting and you must attend? And how would your fellow K4 workers, how would they know to go to the meeting? Who told you? When were you told? How were you told?
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមឆ្លើយអង្គតឡាការសមមេត្តាធានជ្រាបនៅពេលដែលគេចាប់ប្រធានកងវរៈអនុប្រធាននិងសមាជិកកងវរៈកបួននៅទៅគឺមានពួកភូមិភិនិរដីគេមកក្តាប់គេមកក្តាប់នៅអង្គភាពកបួនដូច្នេះពេលហើយប្រជុំគឺពួកនោះ
And did you see whether or not it was the same people that were coming to arrest members of your unit and other units? Was the same people that came every day or every meeting? Or did the faces change?
And
you said that you knew about tool slang and prey sa because you were told it by people that were making the arrest. Is that correct? You were aware of that security facility whilst you were at Khmyon Kopsarai?
ខ្ញុំបាទសូមឆ្លើយបំភ្លឺអង្គតឡាការ ສັ່ງເມຕາຈະຮຽບໃນຂມួយນັງກົບໄສຄືຖະນະພູມພິອະດາຄມີນະນາດັກນໍາ
Thank you. What was the atmosphere like at Khmer Kop Srao? What was the atmosphere like when these arrests were occurring? Every night, people were being taken away from your unit, other people's units. How did you feel being in that atmosphere? Explain to us what it would have been like.
Chambap tom chambap chun ang talaka tom mita chirip nơi pe no aram kư man thật thê tayang chen miang ka prui baram am pi sakde slap rabak khlun tay sa khơn ki chap ra thangay
Thank you. Witness, I'd like to show you a document. I'd like to show you a list with a name on it. And the document number is E3/342. It's the S21 revised prisoner list that contains over 12,000 names of people that were sent to S21. And I'd like to ask you about one name that appears on that list. And Mr. President, I was wondering whether we could show the document on the screen to the witness, if we can enlarge it. For reference, the prisoner number is 8967 on the list. The document gets bigger, Your Honours. It can be enlarged. Whilst we're waiting for that, Your Honour, if I can just put a statement, if I can just put a state, perhaps we'll leave it for today and we'll show the document on Monday. Your Honour, I have a statement to put to the witness that will take about 2 or 3 minutes. If you want to end now, I'm happy to end, otherwise I'll put the statement.
A question, a large question. Đời xa sầm núi này về thông thành đấy.
Bà, ở quân hệ là một bên tâm ra hay của ngày này ngày sọc phòng. Bà, sạm nạc ca ngày này đọc bên chụp tâm ra hay hay ông nhầm rẽ bác phá cái châm nạc ca sạm nạc ca sạp ngày này tâm ra hay sạm nạc ca lực tâm bần tổ phương được ngày chắn thì đọc rắm khai mỹ tuần này chứ nằm bị bọn đọc rắm đây là chạp đàm bị mong bụt bụt bực sạm nạc ca được ngày chắn ສັບດຳສັບດາក្រោយອັງຍໍາແດນຖືສັບນະການບັນຕໍສັບດັບຕະໄຄກຳສະໄສ ហើយសូមភីគីជ្រាបនឹងអញ្ជើញចូលរួមតាមពេលវេលាបានកំណត់នេះអង្គជំរះសូមអរគុណលោកកៅលឿដែលបានដំណើរការសកម្មភាពសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃនេះមិនទាន់ចប់ទេអង្គជំរះក៏អញ្ជើញលោកឲ្យមកផ្ដល់ទៅខែកម្មនៅថ្ងៃច័ន្ទទី15ខែមិថុនាឆ្នាំ2015ដែលនឹងចាប់ផ្ដើមពីម៉ោង9ព្រឹកទៅឥឡូវនេះលោកអាចសម្រាប់បានហើយ មន្ត្រីរដ្ឋបាលតុលាការស្រុកមួយជាមួយនឹងបុគ្គលិកនៃអង្គភាពកោពីសាក់សីនិងអ្នកជំនាញជូនសាក់សីកៅលឿវិលត្រឡប់ទៅកាន់ទីកន្លែងនៃកោះថ្នាក់នៅវិញចុះនិងសូមអញ្ជើញគាត់ត្រឡប់មកចូលរួមសកម្មភាពនៅក្នុងបន្ទប់សន្និសីទការនេះវិញនៅថ្ងៃច័ន្ទដើមសប្តាហ៍ក្រោយនៅវេលាម៉ោង9ព្រឹកហើយប្រកបអនុរិយ៍ទីឃុំឃាំងនាំខ្លួនជនជាប់ចោតតាំងពីរូបនួនជានឹងខៀវសំផនទៅកាន់មន្ទីរឃុំឃាំងនៃអវតកវិញចុះនិ ឲ្យបានមុនម៉ោង9ព្រឹកសម្រាប់ចុះ
សូមអញ្ជើញក្រោកឈរ